There's a hotel close to here, and it's voted the worst hotel in New York.
Nice.
Really?
And I walked by there about a year ago because the paper did something on it. I was trying to figure out a way to maybe...
What's the place?
Shoot a video or something. And I don't know. It's some hellhole, but it's voted the worst hotel in New York to the point where people go by just to take pictures of the fucking place.
Is it called Hotel Empire?
I have no idea. We got to look it up.
I'm just
guessing. I didn't think we were going to talk about this shit today, or I would have done a little research. But it's really close to Midtown. And it's like a tourist stop because it's supposedly horrendous. And people do stay there because it's the worst hotel, all that shit.
Yeah, that's it's probably the worst hotel because, again, there's probably bed bugs. You got to be so careful in New York. Stay at like one of the better ones.
Oh, yes.
The New York Inn?
The New York Inn.
The New York Inn.
Oh, that's
on 8th between 47th and 48th?
It's got to be. That's 8th? About where I think I was. What do they say about it?
Blah blah blah.
For some reason, I don't remember it being called
mice,
the New York
rats,
Inn.
Broken windows, no heat, no hot water, no elevator, decrepit stairs, rude staff, lack of space, leaky plumbing.
Wow, perfect.
Sounds great.
Included breakfast, which is evidently a voucher and a gentle shove towards the nearest Subway sandwich shop.
Wow.
I love how you just described this.
That sounds fucking great.
Can you run through that again? It went by so fast, I was amazed.
Mice, rats, broken window, no heat, no hot water, no elevator, decrepit stairs, rude staff, lack of space, leaky plumbing, breakfast at Subway sandwich shop.
And wow. See, they get a pass because they're shitty owners, obviously, right? But then it gets to a point where they're voted the worst hotel in New York, so now it's a place.
Now it's famous.
Now you're famous, and it's like, why would you fix any of that shit to be just a mediocre hotel?
Mice and rats.
No kidding.
You don't want to stay there?
Fuck, dude, that sounds awful.
You know, that's got to be the dregs of society staying there. They come to New York and just don't even care. Like tourists would come there and just, yeah.
I swear to you, and maybe I'll do it soon. I'll stay there a night
You get
just to check it out.
I mean, their website looks good. It's a budget-friendly Midtown hotel.
Right.
Ideally situated.
Budget-friendly.
Just 2 blocks from Times Square.
Budget-friendly.
Yeah.
You know what?
Budget-friendly.
This is what I'll do. I'll stay the night. I'll roll around with the bed bugs, and then I'll call Kenny in the morning. Kenny will be at my door with fresh clothes. And then I'll just leave my clothes behind, change in the hallway, and get the fuck out.
You could do that.
I bet you that would work.
You won't bring them home if you don't. If you bring a little overnight bag and you put it on, like, you know, the luggage thing that they gave you in the closet. If you put it on that,
right?
Like, you open that up, and you're not going to get them.
Ugh.
Let's stay there. Film some shit.
I don't want no bed bugs.
No? You wouldn't stay at the worst hotel in New York?
No.
You wouldn't go there, Ant?
Never. I need room service.
They don't have an elevator, so you go with the stairs, but the stairs are decrepit.
And I like a good hotel bar. Mm. I like hitting the hotel bar.
TripAdvisor, it's only number 359 in New York out of 430.
Wow.
What does that mean?
In hotels. Like, so it's ranked.
Not the worst.
So it's not the worst.
Not the worst according to TripAdvisor.
You know what?
2.5 stars.
New York Inn doesn't sound familiar to me.
Empire sounds like it to me for some reason.
All right.
There was an article, so I don't know. You got to go back about a year, and they did a whole thing on hotels, the worst hotels in New York or something like that.
Peninsula.
Hotel Carter?
That might be it.
Carter sounds more familiar.
Okay, hang on.
Give me a little street view.
Hang on.
Let's hear about the Hotel Carter.
The Hotel Carter.
What do you mean the street view of the Hotel Carter?
Hotel Carter's on West 43rd.
And what? See, still Midtown-ish. That might be it.
And?
I know I just said that already, but fuck it. I'll say it again. This might be it.
Tell us about it.
Yeah, tell us about the Hotel Carter. You know what? I think this is it. This sounds way more familiar. Are they saying it's
the
worst?
Hotel Carter. Bed bugs, dirty towels in the bathroom, pubic hair everywhere, fungus, graffiti on the furniture, rats that eat your food in the middle of the night, faulty door locks, uncaring staff.
That sounds fantastic. I gotta go.
Well, let's see what their website says.
Wow.
Enjoy the warm hospitality and service at Hotel Carter. A unique and inviting departure from traditional hotels.
It's close to you, man.
That picture...
Oh, that's an old
picture.
It's
from like 19 fucking...
Yeah, this is good. There's a helicopter.
60.
Yeah, there's a helicopter.
It's an old school postcard from, you know, back in the day.
Wow.
It's inviting, it says. It's inviting.
It's inviting.
It's an inviting departure from traditional hotels.
Oh, okay. Oh,
with so 700 it's... rooms, all with private baths. That's great.
You want hey, that? Sure. A bathroom wow, you know? In the room.
Yeah. If you're some schmuck from the Midwest, you're thinking, honey, I think I found our New York City hotel. Look at this. Look at the website.
What else does it say, though? You'll get a...
Yeah, read all the shit from
700 rooms.
Yeah, with 700 rooms, you'll get a close-up view of New York City's Times Square.
Nice.
You can even catch the spectacular ball drop on New Year's.
Oh.
Located in the heart of the theater district in Times Square with major bus and train lines at our front door. We are a half block from the Port Authority bus terminal.
Oh, wow.
Always really good. You really want to be as close there as
possible.
Holy
shit.
This sounds really good. Now go to the reviews again, please.
Yeah, sure.
Reviews.
Here we go, guys.
They're not going to be good.
No. Oh, well, I'd have to go to TripAdvisor. Hang on.
Oh.
All right.
That sounds
this
worse
is a great
than
exercise.
The other place.
It's a What's great exercise, called? Though.
Carter. Hotel Carter.
It's always... Or the description you just read a little while ago. With the pubic hair and all that.
Let's see where they rank.
I like, Hotel Carter.
344.
Out of how many?
430.
Great location, worst hotel ever is one of the reviews?
Yeah.
What do they say? Although I have...
Yes, they have a great location. Staff was attentive. Old and overused beds, dirty rooms. Dirty, and I mean dirty. Bathrooms, mold, extra mold, broken doors, broken curtains, broken lamps, broken furniture, broken windows.
Someone behind the front desk goes, we got the room for you, and you go up.
You go up and everything's...
Here's your key.
Busted and rats and dirty.
It says mold all over the place.
It was a beautiful night of snow showers, and we had snow showers inside the room.
Oh, fuck.
Fantastic location, but poor hotel.
Right. Room very, very dirty.
Ah.
Bathroom and carpet and sheet above all. And quite rumorous, but hotel in a very, very central position.
Near Trafalgar Square.
That sounds like a fucking
That's funny,
crazy.
Man.
The dirtiest and dingiest hotel I've stayed at. Even the bed bugs won't stay here.
Wow. Chip likes that.
Fucking good.
The front desk staff were curt, to say the least, when I complained about the bathroom having mold on the ceiling and affecting my asthma. The receptionist sort of shrugged her shoulders and said, we have no other rooms, and continued to deal with the next person behind me. The beds are lumpy, uncomfortable, and dirty. Even the bed bugs have left. I have traveled a lot. Stands at poorly maintained, dirty hotel. Never again.
Who would
say? Well, you don't know, though. I mean, for us, it's obvious. But you're coming in from another place. You hear Hotel Carter. You're like, that sounds all right. Times Square. Yeah,
please
Times
Square. Read.
Named after a
Do
president.
Do not go here. It is terrible, not clean. Terrible maid service. People say it's good location. Well, yes, it is true. But it is worth your. But is it worth your health? Don't waste your money. You want to pay to suffer? Check in at the local animal shelter. They'll have better rooms for you there.
Wow, this place sounds terrible.
Yeah, we should stay there.
Although someone said not that bad.
Yeah, but someone. You
know. Where was that? We just had a pretty good.
Really not that bad.
3 out of 5 star review.
Oh, my God.
After reading some of the reviews on here, it was with a certain amount of trepidation we checked into this pre-booked hotel for our trip to New York. Yes, it is old, yet it is run down. What a location for the price.
Wow.
We were also pleasantly surprised to find a clean, comfortable room with a huge bed, with a small, serviceable bathroom, and really could not find anything to complain about.
Oh, boy.
Oh,
really?
God.
These are filthy animals.
Signed, the manager.
The sheets and towels were changed every other day. That's good.
Yeah.
I'm not too sure what people expect for the price. I don't know how much it costs.
You know,
let's try to book a room.
But you think about like Damien doing all those years on death row. Like if he stayed there, he'd probably be like, "This is fine. Like
it's great.
It's not great, but compared to where I was,
yeah,
mosquitoes crawling all over me. This is fucking the digs.
Holy fuck! I like the one review where everything was broken. That's just hilarious.
Just busted.
Yeah, how much is this?
I'm trying to find out.
But. I would love to have Kenny check the Hotel Carter for me for a guest. You know, James, it's no good, Jim.
Oh, God, imagine that. You just send him there.
Yeah.
See what he says.
Everything seems to be booked up.
Yeah, because a lot of people come here, I guess, with no money, right?
Wait, they're booked?
$99 rooms are showing. Look.
Wow. In fucking Midtown?
I think this is the place that the paper wrote about.
Probably. That's pretty good.
Yeah.
Any night that I try, it's booked up.
Do you see all those prices right there?
Oh, where?
Right with, there, all the prices.
Wait, with all those shitty reviews,
I'm
and
checking red, which is obviously booked. Oh, yeah, $99.
$99.
But it's booked.
Yeah.
Hotels in New York City go for $300, $400, $500.
Easy.
Yeah.
And then they raise it from there.
Yep.
$500, $600, $700 if something's happening.
These are broke people. Who knows why people are coming here? It could be they're coming here just to visit or, whatever it is.
Well, you save money on the sleeping so you can spend more money out and about. I like the one where it was snowing in their room.
But there's a reason it's so cheap.
There's a reason it's so cheap. Stayed here for one night. Had to ask to move room twice. First room, smoke alarm would not stop beeping. Second, toilet was leaking all over the floor. Plugs are hanging out of the walls with wires showing. Hotel is dirty, old, and cheap. Cheap for New York City, but I would recommend staying somewhere else if you can afford it.
Only 70 pounds a night, sorry. 70 pounds a night. So they flew across the ocean stayed there.
Yes. Doesn't that make you so happy?
It's so terrible.
But now people are going to go there.
Not at all disappointed. There's, there's some people with very low expectations.
Yes.
Who knew it was terrible for? They probably expected a dump for $99.
Yeah. And now we fly back to the Sudan.
Yeah, they're probably leaving their house that is filled with, cat poo.
Yes.
This reminds me of the place I was declitted. Oh, wow. I'm warning you, do not stay.
That guy has a long review. Right,
this guy's pissed. Yeah,
we came in early. The room wasn't ready. They let us leave our luggage at their storage room with a fee of $2 a bag. We left one lady's purse, a backpack, and a luggage bag.
Uh-oh.
The guy said we could put them all together as one. Went out and explored the city.
Came back,
found out that one of the bags wasn't there anymore.
Nice.
Asked if you could call, check security cams. Manager said, we cannot. You have to call 911.
So their bag was ripped off?
We went to the NYPD, told them what happened. Two officers went with us, blah, blah, blah.
And even if they were saying the hotel should be able to get access to their own cameras without police present. Yeah. But I was glad they still came back. They would view the cameras, and it showed someone just took the bag over the counter while the security person was supposedly wasn't there.
Oh, my God.
It was so obvious that it was negligence on the hotel's part. Wow.
Huh. Yeah, we should stay here.
Sounds good. Thieves, busted shit.
What? Jesus, he's the worst. You know these mics work, right?
Good morning, guys.
Hi, Mars.
What do you got there? It says crack. It's another MMA shirt.
Why would you whisper knowing the mics are going to pick it up? You're an audio engineer.
Travis.
I think everyone heard. How about videos on YouTube.
How about some gay sex later?
Yeah.
You like your ass eaten after a hard day of sitting and Googling?
Same time, same place.
Wow, yeah, look at this. There's some fucking YouTube.
My Carter Hotel experience. Can we turn the volume up on it?
Yeah, sure.
They're playing some music. They're showing New York City.
They're showing the New York Times building. This looks nice.
Times Square.
Times Square, 2009, so they came in town for the ball drop. Music is lowering.
Now they're showing all this panoramic views of New York and
pigeons. Okay, this looks like it might be the hotel.
Very New York-y. Garbage. Okay.
Garbage everywhere.
It's getting uglier.
Yeah, somehow the...
Oh, they're showing everything.
I love New York coffee mugs.
It's just a bunch of scenes of Times Square.
Sure.
Hotel Carter.
All right, here we go. Hotel Carter. Hotel Carter.
All right.
Again.
Yeah, you will always... You always wanted in the Times Square and let. What's this?
I don't know what that is.
This is it. Because I walked up into the lobby. And
he's
then...
opening it and walking up the steps.
The music gets ominous.
All right. It looks like the start of a horror movie. The following footage you are about to see was taken on February 6th and 7th of 2009.
Oh, dirty rugs.
Major dirty stains on the rug. One block away from Times Square.
Right now, just
the Hotel Dixie opened on April 22nd, 1930.
It's changed names over there.
It is 24 stories high, and on its opening had 1,000 rooms.
Wow. 1,000 rooms? This guy.
In 1977, Tran Dung Chong bought the Hotel Dixie and changed it to its current name, the Hotel Carter.
Hotel Carter!
Oh, he's an Asian guy, yeah.
Always, yeah.
Oh, Hotel Carter always here.
From the time of Mr. Tran's ownership, the events in the building have increasingly become disturbingly bad or something.
Oh, what is that?
Wow, horrible stains. That looks like a blood stain.
Blood.
Mr. Tran's a shitbag. Wow, look at the broken light in the fucking
lights in the hallway, just tilted. That's a fire hazard.
Fucking flop house. It looks like. Wow.
Is that it?
That's part one.
Oh no! All right, here we go.
Wow.
Plaster is just falling off the wall.
New York sued the Carter for its failure to. Are they playing Radiohead?
Wait, the fucking, he was...
It's going by too fast, unfortunately. This idiot doesn't know how to do graphics on a video.
Can you just pause for a second?
Yeah,
like,
pause.
There's a sign, it was 831, 839, and it's like, written in marker.
On a piece of sheet metal that's literally nailed to the wall.
Right.
In marker.
All right, there's plaster
all chipped
off.
What's that?
Wall in the hallway. Yeah, read this shit, Jimmy, please. Got the plaster.
Plaster all over the dirty. In 83 and 84, City sued Carter for failure to correct numerous infractions. As a result, Mr. Tran was held in contempt of court and had to pay a $10,000 fine.
In 85.
Yeah, 80, wow.
Righteous.
They're just showing a filthy montage of dork.
Holy fuck, everything just rotting.
Graffiti
on the doors.
Between 84 and 88, he turned the hotel into a homeless shelter.
Oh man.
Boy.
Holes. I need to make money.
Pause. I mean, the guy's a pretty good filmmaker because it's. But there's just holes punched through the doors of your room.
Yeah.
There's graffiti on a bunch of the doors.
Who says this place is okay?
The building was neglected. Is
not
what
bad
up to.
For $100.
Hey, you
building
know
was
what?
Neglected. Yeah, it's terrible. It's like all just. And criminal activity was disturbing and brutal.
Nice.
Holy fuck.
This is the 80s, though.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, he's going to update it.
In 83, a resident beat his 25-day-old infant child to death.
Jesus.
Wow. In 88, all families were removed from the Carter due to issues of plumbing, electricity, security, and vermin. Wow. In 89, a relative of Tran was sued for bribing a building inspector in an effort to not get a fire safety violation. This Tran's awful.
This guy had it because he knows he was tricked.
In 87, a woman was thrown out of a window from one of the top floors. When the police found her body, she was hardly clothed and her arms were tied behind her back.
Nice. This place is great.
It's rules. In 1988, wow.
That's when we moved to New York.
Carter was temporarily closed due to damaged fire escape. December of 99, Sean Combs and girlfriend Jennifer Lopez arrived at a club that used to be located, what?
Yeah, this goes so fast.
It used to be located on the first floor.
Pause.
Okay.
Wait, this was the place where that's where the shooting was, right?
Was it? Let's see.
They're just showing filthy rugs. A shooting occurred that police accused Combs and a friend were responsible for starting.
Oh.
That was there?
I guess that was. An innocent bystander was shot in the face.
I remember that.
Oh, they're just showing dirty door handles. Although Combs was found not guilty, his limo driver was made a police report stating that Combs offered him $50,000 to admit that the gun he had was his.
Remember that?
Yeah, of course.
That doesn't have anything to do with the hotel.
I didn't know it was the Carter.
In also 99, a clerk murdered a fellow coworker during a brawl near the front desk.
Fuck! Use a hammer and a knife to
do
the
brutal
killing. Is this the Overlook?
Yeah. Oh, it stopped right there. You know, in 1921, a caretaker murdered his wife and children
and
when they stole
daughters.
Matches and tried to burn it down. Yes, a man was playing handball against the wall and scuffed it. A 2005 building engineer was killed due to blood leaking out of it. No, due to a freak elevator malfunction.
So, a building engineer in 2005.
Only 7 patches required.
Oh, fuck.
In September of 07, wow. Serial sex offender Clarence Dean murdered a woman in room 608.
Who the fuck would stay here?
This place is amazing.
Convicted serial murderer. Dean strangled the girl, left her under the room's bed until a maid found her 12 days later.
I remember that.
Pause. You do?
Yeah. I remember the body under the bed for so many days, and people were actually going in and sleeping and staying in the room with the dead body under the bed, and someone started complaining about a smell.
It was
and then
under
they just
the,
didn't care.
Was it under the bed, or did they take the bed frame out?
It was a platform
out?
Bed, yeah. Right. Remember that? A platform bed. They took the mattress out, put her in the little platform thing, and then put the box spring and mattress back down.
Oh, my God.
Holy shit.
Yeah, I do recall that. Yeah.
I sort of remember that now,
this is insane. This fucking hotel's insane.
Yeah.
Wow, Wiz is dingy looking.
Horrible. A lot of edits.
There's so many bad scenes he's showing. Just so much garbage.
Graffiti and shit just rotting off the walls.
Yeah.
The numbers
a towel
on the room.
In front of the fucking... Sorry, a towel in front of the door because there's a leak of some sort.
The numbers on the rooms are those stick-on numbers that you see people, the cheap ones they put on their mailboxes.
Just buy them at the hardware store.
Yeah, yeah.
Everything.
Wow.
Love this.
Every lock on the doors look like they've been hit with
hammers. In 09, the Hotel Carter was voted the dirtiest hotel in the U.S. for the fourth time in a row.
There you go.
Yeah.
We found it.
Why wouldn't he clean it? In the U.S.
I need to make money.
Because he knows people will just stay there.
I woke up to a bunch of guys breaking into our room while we were asleep. The room had four locks on the door, and all of them were broken by the men except for the chain lock.
Holy shit. I guess these are quotes of people's reviews.
No, it's this guy.
Oh.
No, guess.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
That's from Philly.
Right.
Motherfucking Philly.
Wow. I love the quotes.
Just horrible.
Yeah, gang graffiti. Fucking. Gang
oh my graffiti. God, this dirt just piled up in the corner. Was that a rat nest?
A rat nest,
oh,
yeah.
Oh, wow.
Just in the hallway?
Yep.
Wow. Oh. Hostile guests to go to any other floor. Oh.
Prohibited for hostile guests.
It's a hostel, too.
Oh, God.
In the next segment, you will see my experience in room 839.
Oh, fuck. We're all dead.
I think there was a nude woman in the tub. She looked attractive at first.
839. Wow, that's a, we're all in. Let's
you
go
don't
part
go
two.
Go to room 839, Doc.
Yeah.
E-Rod, get this video up on our Facebook page.
Right, do you like rats nest, Doc?
And explain why it's up there for the people that, you know, maybe won't hear this show today.
You want to do part two?
Oh, God, yeah. Sure. More than I want fucking, there's a new Star Trek.
Oh.
He's holding the 839. So his hands up. He's wearing gloves.
Oh,
the eighth floor.
He's not supposed to go in there.
Yeah.
839.
I'm not supposed to.
Who says you're not supposed to? He's just it's just silent footage of him walking down this fucking dirty hallway.
Every bit of metal is punched in, too.
Yeah.
Like anything that could be punched and dented is.
Well, the Dixie was probably nice.
Oh, yeah. Ah, the Dixie. I want to stay in the serial killer room, please.
Why wouldn't you make some effort just to keep it kind of clean? Like,
man, I don't know if I could stay here now.
Why not? He's pushing the door open.
There he goes. All right. And all right. What
this is his room.
It's a few rooms. He opens it. There's a big garbage can.
What the fuck is this?
It's a hallway with a few. Oh, he's just showing you the hallway.
Oh, he's in.
He's just kind of showing the floor he's on.
Oh, okay. That's like a utility room or something. It was filthy.
Okay. Yeah, he's just.
So you open up a.
Walking back down the hall.
Right.
He's just showing the walls.
Yeah, he passed his room a while ago. He's just showing the floor.
Yeah.
But the rug is
very,
awful.
Just very dingy.
Sounds quiet, though.
Nice.
Inside room 839, the closet. Hold on.
His
wires are hanging down. The rug is filthy.
There's no door on the closet. It's
the bed isn't even made.
Wow.
I'm sure he's just checking into his room. So
nice TV.
Oh, his camera and stuff are on the awful fucking nightstand.
Holy shit, the furniture's horrendous.
Graffiti inside the drawers.
And I'm doing a little bit more investigational work.
Here we go.
Old 2006-2007 phone book.
A phone book.
Somebody wrote something in 1995.
Wow.
Big Van Halen fan, I guess. Says VH.
I hope they're still... whatever.
Oh, couples that are together. So yeah. Like, you know, so-and-so.
Like falling apart.
Wow, the bed's falling out of the fucking wall.
Holy shit. The headboard of the bed is pulled out of the wall. You see nails.
It's pretty.
An old fucking phone on the...
A dingy dresser. Oh, my God.
With no handles anymore. The bed's not made.
Very old, nasty little air conditioner in the window.
You can see the box spring.
It's a window unit.
You can see wires that are such a fire hazard.
Wires and steam pipes that are going into holes that are... Like, just, you could tell mice have been chiseling away at things.
Sure.
Oh, the door is all...
All moldy, and it looks like people have tried to jimmy the lock every...
This is new. This is totally brand new. Wow. Pretty ghetto.
All right, pretty ghetto. A light fixture that's been twisted.
With a bug just...
big bug in it, right?
Yeah, making its way up to the top of it.
At 6, I return to my main headquarters at the Mayfair Hotel, 6 blocks away from the Carter for a nap. Oh, she's not staying there.
It's now 1 o'clock in the morning, New York time, and I'm going back to the Carter Hotel now to go check it out.
to be perfectly honest, I'm very scared. And, you know, it really wasn't. I mean, the overall look of the building is very scary in general, but it was just kind of the feeling of the building. It felt really awful. But I'm going to go back and we're going to see what's
Blair Witch.
Going on with Carter.
All right, 1 in the morning, room 89 continued, looking a little deeper.
Should a home base at the Mayfair?
No. Oh, dirty sheets.
Really?
What is that? What is on that?
Oh, it's blood.
It's like blood.
That's blood. That's probably from bed bugs. Because that's when you see that blood stuff, that's from a bed bug. Oh, it's on the pillow.
Ah. Yeah, it's on the pillow.
Ah. Wow.
On the bed that's not made. Now she's pulling everything off the bed to get to the
sheets to get to the mattress.
Oh, big fucking piss stains on the mattress. And
oh, my God.
Blood stains.
Blood stains.
Wow.
That's like a period.
Or a giant. It's like a giant circular piss stain or whatever
stain.
It is.
Piss stain. And then some blood. Oh, yeah. Oh, the pillow. The pillow's ripped. All the foam is coming
it's
out of the pillow.
Out of the pillow.
Because she pulled the pillow out of the pillowcase.
Oh, God.
It's stained.
Yuck.
It's yellow. The pillow is yellow.
Would you stay here, Jimmy?
No. I would execute Kenny if he booked this. I did it with miles.
How many? 1 mile.
1 mile.
That's all you need. Merely a mile.
Wow, man.
The horrible fucking.
Oh,
wow.
My God.
The filthy stained corner of the bottom box of the mattress.
It's blood on
the box
it's
spring.
Fucking blood.
It looks like there's just a lot of old blood on this one.
It's filthy. Caked with filth.
This, what is that? Is that where they put Lincoln? After his little theater experience.
You should stay in the room for the night.
No.
This lady's doing a documentary.
These are so dirty.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. Who would
just
stay?
Imagine the filthiest mattress, really.
Uh-huh.
I don't think I've seen worse.
So,
yes.
I'm in my room right now, and I was just taking apart the bedspreads and the pillows and whatnot, as you saw in the previous footage, and I just took apart the entire bed to try to get a better look at this blood that's all over this mat, this spring box. Here is the box spring.
Uh-oh. So we were right. It was blood. Holy
shit. Wow, what's going
shit.
On there?
The foot of the box spring is just
wow.
A shitload of blood. And then it looks like a dragged blood stain.
Is that where the dead body was or no?
I don't know.
Probably not. I wouldn't. Oh, man.
There is
what
so
is
much
that?
Blood.
What's going on there?
Caked on it.
Caked on the bottom of this box spring.
Hilarious.
Wow. This has to be bed bugs.
That
here.
Could be bed bugs. It really could be.
That's,
and that,
that's a lot of
yeah,
blood.
Yeah, not that much.
That's a lot of blood. Come on.
Yeah. It also looks like the mattress could have been standing up and been wet and it was running down.
Maybe,
it.
Yeah.
Like, she's saying it's blood. It kind of
yeah,
looks like it could not. I'll take her word for
like
it.
It could be.
It's
yeah.
Red.
It's red, right?
Brownish, yeah. Oh, nice plug.
Horrible
that
plug in
dangerous.
The bathroom.
You wouldn't plug anything into
oh,
that.
Oh, my God. Oldie time life. But, oh, the shower.
All right. Shower.
Filthy spigot.
Oh, my God. The water's brown or something.
The water was...
It was brown, right?
Oh!
What?
Uh-oh, what? What, lady?
The brown water. Oh.
Oh.
The water was brown. Coming out of the fucking shower.
The garbage can is so fucking dirty.
Oh, God. No bag in it. Bag.
Oh.
What? The toilet looks alright.
Is there like...
The toilet doesn't look bad. The plumbing's horrendous, but the yeah. Toilet...
So, I just left Carter Hotel, and as I was leaving, one of the lovely bellboys decided to leave me this nice little present that was sitting in his pocket for probably the last, like, 7.5 years. He has a crush on me, and...
looks like one of those chocolate-covered cherries.
Front tooth, and I'm throwing... whatever date rape drug he just gave me.
She returned to the Mayfair Hotel at 3 a.m.
Mm. I guess she liked the Mayfair.
She returned to the Carter at 9 a.m. to check out.
Okay.
This was what I discovered.
Oh, shit.
Oh, okay.
The thing is when I got into my room that I was supposed to sleep in last night, I noticed that the bathroom...
At this point in the footage, I suddenly felt the urge to look around the room, she said. I was scared that someone else was in the room.
I didn't use the bathroom at all.
Wow, the toilet's
just... pee on the seat.
Oh, no.
Toilet paper in the bowl.
And piss on
and
the seat.
Piss on the seat.
Somebody came in to my room.
Right.
I cannot believe what has happened. I'm getting out of here right now.
Somebody came into the room.
The hotel probably doesn't activate their key cards for specific rooms, which means that one key card enables you to get into every room in the building. The guy at the desk was delighted that I even bothered checking out and returning the key card.
Wow.
Before I left, I filmed the hotel's lobby trying not to look suspicious. Soon after, a guard approached me and said the filming was not allowed.
Yeah, great.
Wow. That's not a nice place.
Jesus.
That was kind of creepy, no?
Yeah, man. Somebody used our bathroom.
That's fucked up.
When she should have been sleeping in that room.
She would have been in the room sleeping and someone would have just come in.
Supposedly, Louis had some kind of like that happen to him in Russia. Like he came back and there was somebody in his room or something when he went to Moscow.
Really?
Yeah. Her room at the Mayfair. Where I received over 50 bed bug bites. Wow.
Although this was very painful and embarrassing, I would still pick this place over the Carter Hotel.
Look at her stuff all over the fucking bed.
Yeah.
By the way, when you go back, you can see on her, it looks like on her neck she has a couple of little red bumps.
Yeah. Oh, my God.
50 bed bug bites.
Horrible. Yeah, that's definitely the place.
Horrible.
Who is this woman? Why'd she do it?
Yeah, well, a little documentary.
But,
aspiring filmmaker or something?
50 bed bug bites.
You probably heard about it. I mean, people know about this place, and they stay there because it's so awful.
She had her shit laid all over the bed. I would love to contact her and say, did you get bed bugs at home?
Bring them home. What kind of date rape drug in that chocolate-covered cherry?
Let me go to Tony. Tony, what's up, buddy?
Hey, yeah.
Hey, I grew up in Buffalo. We took a class trip to New York City, like in 86, 87. I forget when, but cheapest place to stay was the Carter, so we all stayed at the Carter. And I mean, you walked in, it was like a shooting gallery with like just drug addicts and prostitutes just hanging around, and it was just absolutely disgusting and... You know, being 17 or 16, I was like, wow, this is the greatest place in the world. Times Square was unbelievable back then, right? With all the three-card money and anything you can do. But
good old days.
I don't know, like 3 months later or something, 60 Minutes did a expose, like the worst hotel in America. And like all the parents were outraged that, you know, that the teacher put us kids in harm's way with that.
Oh, shit.
Can we find their expose? I would love to see that.
A teacher decided that was the hotel.
Yeah. Could you see if you can find the 60 Minutes expose?
On what? I'm sorry. I was trying to figure out how to get on
the Carter. Hopefully YouTube or something. Yeah. They did an expose.
60 Minutes on the Carter?
Yeah, yeah, okay. Yeah.
Or on the worst hotels.
Do you want me to send this girl a message? Yeah. Like, do you have any interest in talking to her?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah, sure.
She still checks her. She signed into YouTube yesterday, so she's still.
Yeah, absolutely. We can talk to her tomorrow if we don't get her today.
Yes.
Thank you, sir. He's gone.
She's in Oregon, so I doubt we'd talk to her today.
Right.
Yeah, right.
She looked
maybe tomorrow.
Like she was
or
from
maybe
Oregon,
late,
didn't she?
Later in the show.
She had a Pacific Northwest look to her, didn't she?
Yeah, a little eye ring. Like a,
yeah.
But I
thought
I saw a couple of red welts, and that's probably what that was from.
Holy.
50 bed bug bites.
From
that's
the better
terrible.
Hotel.
Both of those videos are on our Facebook page.
Hers?
Yeah,
our Facebook page?
The ones that we just watched.
Are on our
Facebook. Just so if anybody wants to
check it out.
Yeah, you gotta see it for yourself.
Hotel Carter, New York CBS.
You would have sworn that that place was abandoned for like 10 years, and she just opened up some, you know, some doors and took a look around.
Oh, that was pictures from CBS.
Yeah, that was just a top 10.
Oh, okay.
America's Dirtiest.
This place is famous for being fucking a shithole.
Yeah.
So who would stay there?
Well, because it's a shithole and it's famous for being a shithole, that's enough for people to stay there. That's how that shit works.
I don't get it.
If the guy fixed it up a little bit, he would be fucked. People would be like, what the fuck?
People come here.
This is my time here.
People come here. Love the shithole.
What was the worst part? Like the gang graffiti on your hotel?
I think somebody walking into your
room
fucking room in the middle of the night.
Just the filth and grime and blood on the mattress and blood on the pillow.
Ugh.
That's fucking horrible, man.
Ugh.
How's he still in business?
Why doesn't the city just shut him down?
Yeah, the Board of Health or something, no?
Yeah, he's probably got what they call, you know, those rights that they give people for things like this. They shouldn't just fucking throw him out of the city.
Yeah.
Tran! Ah! Better than hotel I come from Vietnam!
Yeah.
Yeah.
He probably ran the fucking,
the POW camp.
Yeah, what's it called? The Hanoi Hilton.
I was manager of Hanoi Hilton.
All right.